Hello everyone, and welcome back to more Illusion of Gaia. We're gonna go check this area out. I don't like the sound of this. Oh no, wait, I wanna go back! No, I don't wanna fight anything! Well, I figured we would have to fight something. Call it intuition. This guy's kinda mean. He flies around, and he shoots his feathers at you, and apparently he's really strong, which is not cool, and I don't want to have to do this, but it looks like I have to. We need to use an herb. Good thing we just got one, so, you know, we can do that stuff. I'm gonna kind of cheat to kill this guy, because I can. As long as he sits still. You need to stop moving, sir. I need to kill you. You don't understand. I need to kill you. This game will not let me progress until you die! Okay, that said something, but I don't get to see what it is. Let's try rewind. You defeated the huge demon. Look, a mystic statue! Okay, how could you catch anything falling like that? But, whatever. Our second mystic statue. Second? Oh my gosh, wow. I am not nearly as far as I thought I was. And it looks like we're transforming back into Will. Boo. I mean, yay! A strange noise fills the air around you. From out of nowhere, you hear Nell's voice. I don't know if it's Nell or Neil. Let's call him Neil. Will, you're falling to the ground. Grab the airplane, we'll fly out of here. He's got an airplane? Alright, cool. Let's go. I'm down. A little parachuting. Oh my gosh. Oh, he just... Aw, crap. I dropped a contact. You what? Idiot! Will is doomed for sure now. Neil, it's still a little ways to the ground. Try again. I'll get him this time. He better, because I am not trying to die. Whew. That was close. Looks like we're safe. Riding on the top of the airplane, you know, because there's totally seats there. And then the one guy's riding on the tail. I guess he's not any safer. Gee, I hope we don't run out of fuel. That would kind of suck. That was a close one. Don't cry. Will's been saved. Neil, you were great. This invention saved Will's life. Don't flatter me. We should try and locate the next ruins. I expect the shape of the Cygnus is the same as the shape of Mu. Mu? Well... To the ocean. Mu lies somewhere in this ocean. Well, we're in an airplane, so, you know, can't really do anything with an ocean. I guess this airplane has unlimited fuel? I'm not really sure. Apparently, oh, that's not good. It's not good at all. Good thing we have parachutes. Looks like our trip is cut short. I got out of the airplane in the nick of time. Neil's a good inventor, but it seems there's always something missing in his inventions. I guess nobody's perfect, including Neil. You forget to mention the fact that we're falling to the sea in a parachute. The next thing he knew, Will was standing in a huge palace. I couldn't remember anything since my water landing. Is everyone safe? I don't know. We have to find out. That's odd. Even if it touches, no damage occurs. That is odd. And I can't really hurt it either. Well, at least there's an area to dark space. Not that we need to be here, but at least we can save. I'm kind of mad that Gaia doesn't give you any information. Like, never tells you, like... Gives you like an idea of where to go next, but a sign of life from the right-hand room. Will, where is it? What? You found a red jewel. Well, it looks like Kara, but it's... That's odd. What? I hear a soft voice from somewhere. This is the Palace of Vampires. The fountain in this palace produces demons continuously. Palace of Vampires, that's great. I've always wanted to go to the Palace of Vampires. So this place is like a kind of, like a little maze. In the basement of this castle is a strange fountain. The stone is there. Hurry! So, we have to go to the basement of this castle. Easier said than done, of course. The purification stone in the castle. So, apparently there's a purification stone in this castle. I believe you're going the right way as long as you keep hearing the voices. I mean, usually hearing voices is a bad thing, at least that's what they tell me, but, you know. My doctor's been saying hearing voices is bad. Well, not true, because Will hears voices too, and it's just like the game. Coffins are all lined up. Oh, great, this one's open. That means one of these vampires in this palace are roaming free and walking around and looking for me and stuff. Finally have some stuff to kill, and it's little gel blobs. Really? That does not make for an interesting video. That does not make for an interesting video. Little tiny blob gel things are not cool, man. And they're odd little colors. Purple and blue and stuff. They look kind of cool when they fall, though. Aside from that, though, that's pretty much it. God, there sure are a lot of these little stupid things. Well, I guess we'll kill them all. Might as well. It's over here. Oh, gee, thanks for the information, guys. I really needed that. I think the blue blobs are enemies that don't die. Okay, maybe not. It doesn't say there's a force here, though, so... may not be able to get... experience power-ups, but I'm gonna try anyway, because I should. Just have to kill a couple enemies, and that's cool, because as long as they don't hit me, I don't really have a problem with them. More little gel guys. You guys are getting annoying. I would like to fight something different than little stupid gel things. Let's go up for a change and see what's up here. Oh, that's right. That's that room. I don't need to be in that room. I guess the only way to go is down. So this must be the fountain. Where's this purification stone I've heard so much about? That's odd. There's no stone here. Why don't we try playing something? It's odd. Well, I don't see any demons here, so I don't know what they're talking about. Palace where demons are born from the pond, I don't see crap. Unless you really do have to kill all these guys. I mean, that would kind of suck, but maybe that is what you have to do. Unless, was there another door over here? Yeah, there is. What is in said door? Treasure chest. You found a red jewel. Well, not what I'm looking for, but we'll do that. Maybe I have to go to the top of the castle? Or another spot where this purification stone is supposed to be? Not really sure. Been a while since I've played this, obviously. You guys know that. So I'm not too keen on the direction that I need to be going in. Maybe I came here too early. Maybe I do have to go up. Let's try going up. That one leads down. I think we're going the right way. Not really sure. I'm just running around in circles. I'm pretty sure about that. There's a treasure chest that we haven't got. kind of want to know what's in there. Lest that be the purification stone, which would be kind of nice, but it's probably just an herb. I don't know what that said. Figures. Found a red jewel. Okay. Let's do that. Nothing over here. Let's check this room over here. Okay. What is this place? Dark and lonely. Mother, save me. Alright. So apparently people are really scared about this place. And I just went the wrong way again. Because I'm trying to go up. And that is right here. I can go right here. What was it? Oh, that's right. That's Kara. So wait, are we at the top of this place? Like, is this as high as you can go? Like, there's really no way out of this place? Like, it's just a maze? Really? That would kind of suck. Because, you know, that fountain... There's obviously something to do with that fountain, and I'm pretty sure I've been in all these little rooms and talked to all my little friends, so I don't think they have anything to do with it, unless one of these skeletons knows some sort of secret. But, I don't think they do, because I think they're just there just to show you that something's not quite right in this area. But like I said, it's been a while since I played this, so they might have to do with something. Oh. Wow. You scared me. I practically had a heart attack. I saw Eric in the other room, but something strange. His body is half transparent. I can see through it. He seems to be unconscious, as if his spirit is lost. Let's stick together. We don't know what will happen. Probably need to go down to the purification thing with Lily. Since Lily is not affected, as aren't you. As aren't you? Lily is unaffected like you. I believe Lily is key to figuring out this little plot. This little puzzly thing. So, we'll go back to that fountain room. After we get hit, because, you know, we don't remember that we need to block and kill stuff. I'm gonna just dodge these guys, because I really don't think there's anything to do with killing them. So, I'm just gonna go ahead and dodge them. So, back here again, and it doesn't look like anything's here. Let's try to play that melody again. Figures, nothing happens. Alright, so what? We don't need to be here yet? We don't have to come here at all? I came here too soon? God, I wish this game would just stop with this and just show me where the heck to go. Or, you know, not even that. Just don't have these stupid time sequences where you have to come back after you do, like, one stupid little thing. Like, why can't it just let me go to the place I want to go to and do what I want to do? Why does it have to be so cinematic like this? I mean, I get it adds to the challenge, and it's supposed to be puzzle and entertaining and stuff, but it just kind of makes me frustrated. And now it looks like I'm going to die, which is kind of going to suck. But that's okay. Because we used up a life, and that is fine. Interesting. So we obviously don't have to be in that room yet. That's what I'm going to assume. So let's go up. We'll go back up to where we started. See if we can't talk to Kara or something. Ooh, wait. Wait a minute, isn't there a hole in the coffin? I could get a better look through the hole. I better have a look. There's a key fastened inside this coffin. No wonder it didn't open. So you can send Lily into these holes. Interesting. I found a strange stone inside this coffin. Let me guess, purification stone? Yay! So now we have to go down to that room again. And we have to use this purification stone, which just looks like a tiny little rock. That's weird. So I guess we throw the rock in the water and something happens, just like Zelda. Alright, fine. Now you jerks have to die. Getting annoying. Wait, it's a strange fountain. Duh. Could there be a connection between this and the rock? Stone began to glow, then disappeared into the spring. Oh, so stones can hover. Let's just stay here, though, so, you know, because stones that can hover, that's not bad. That's good. So the water turns to blue, and I guess that means this place is purified now. Should be able to talk to our friends, I'm guessing. And I'm also guessing that the skeleton guys are gone. But these blobs are probably still here. Oh, wait. Thank you. I was brought to this place from Phrygia and changed into a demon. What? All the demons we saw before were human beings? That explains why there's no force here. I know now what it feels like to be close to death. Death is terrifying. I wonder if the animals we eat feel the same way I felt before death. You probably don't want to think too much about that, because then you won't eat anymore and you'll probably die. Alright, so next time we're going to see what happens now that the curse is lifted and see if we can find a way out of here. And what about those vampire guys? Are we going to have to fight them? A boss again? We just did one. Well, we'll see. Next time.